Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the social science class. So, in a previous class, we had discussed the topic role of technology, Rinderpest or cattle plague. And today we are going to talk about the indentured labor migration from India. So, the word indenture here means a bonded laborer under contract to work for an employer, and that too for a specific amount of time. So, what happened in the 19th century, the migration of indentured labor from India showed two scenarios. The first scenario showed faster economic growth, and the second scenario showed great misery. So, in the 19th century, thousands of Indian and Chinese laborers went to work on plantations, in mines, and in road and railways construction projects all around the world. Then in the mid of 19th century, the areas from where the indentured workers came experienced many changes. Like, there was decline in industries, then lands were cleared for mines and plantations, and all these affected the lives of the poor, and they were forced to migrate in search of work. The laborers were recruited by agents, and these agents tempted them to work. But the laborers soon were under a new system of slavery. So, in order to survive, these laborers discovered their own ways. Hose and chutney music are the two expressions of the post-indenture experience. Then later on in the 1921, the system of indentured labor migration was banned. Then the next topic is Indian trade, colonialism and the global system. So, in India, you had Shroffs and Chettiars who were working as bankers and traders at that time. They were financing things that were exported from India in Central and South Asia with funds that they borrowed from Europe during that time. Then there were Hyderabadi Sindhis who also ventured beyond European colonies. Then if you talk about the Indian trade and colonization, in the early 19th century, India faced tough competition from Britain. Why? Because Britain at that time provided cheap cotton cloth. But during this time, the export of raw material increased. Why? Because Europe was requiring a lot of raw material during that time. So, that was important development that took place at that time. Now, if we talk about the interwar period, it was very, very important. Because during the World War, there was snapping of economic links between some of the world's largest economic powers, which were now fighting with each other to pay for them. After the war was over, there was a lot of unemployment which increased and which resulted in criminal activities. But this scenario was affected by the development done in America. In America, Henry Ford produced cars at that time. So, Henry Ford was the largest producer of cars at that time. And what did he do? He produced these cars in mass. But the problem was there that the workers of the manufacturing company did not want to work. So, in order to make them work, he paid them double wages. So, this scenario brought in a lot of prosperity in America because of the development of many things also. Then our next topic will be the Great Depression that we will be discussing in our next class. The homework for you is to read the chapter. Thank you.